Hello and welcome to the Magic of Mathematics channel. My name is Manohar Murthy and you are watching one amongst a series of videos exploring the world of mathematics. In this video, I intend to arrive at a method for constructing the perpendicular bisector of a line segment using a scale and a geometric compass. For this, I will use the fact that the diagonals of a rhombus bisect each other at right angles. Let us assume that we have to construct the perpendicular bisector of a line segment AB. Essentially, what this means is that we have to draw a line bisecting this line segment at right angles. If we think of the given line segment as one of the diagonals of a rhombus, clearly our job is to construct the other diagonal, since the diagonals of a rhombus bisect each other at right angles. We know that the endpoints of the diagonal AB, namely points A and B, form two of the vertices of our rhombus. For drawing the other diagonal, we need to identify the other two vertices of our rhombus. Let us see how we can do that. For this, let us assume that we already have a rhombus ACBD with line segment AB as one of its diagonals. Since the four sides of a rhombus are of equal measure, we can conceptualize such a rhombus as being formed by two isosceles triangles of the same dimensions, namely triangles ACB and BDA, standing on a common base AB. Clearly, if we can construct two such triangles, we would have identified the other two vertices of our rhombus, and once we identify these vertices, we just need to draw a line passing through them, thereby obtaining the perpendicular bisector of line segment AB. What is worth noting here is that we don't actually need to draw the sides of our two isosceles triangles. All we need to do is to identify the remaining vertices of these two triangles. For identifying these vertices, I'll make use of the method for constructing a triangle given its three sides. Clearly, for each of the two isosceles triangles that I need to construct, the line segment AB forms one of the sides. For the remaining two equal sides, I can choose any measurement as long as I choose the same measurement for both the equal sides of both our triangles. All I need to ensure is that the measurement I choose results in a triangle being formed. I will accomplish this by measuring an arbitrary radius of more than half the length of the line segment AB on a compass. Then, with point A as the center, I will draw an arc above line segment AB as shown. Now, using point B as center, I will draw an arc of the same radius as before, intersecting my previously drawn arc at point C. Using the same radius, I will repeat the exercise below line segment AB, resulting in the point of intersection D. I now have the remaining two vertices of my rhombus. All I need to do is to draw a line through these two points. As we know, this is the perpendicular bisector of the given line segment, and hence my construction is complete. In this video, I have arrived at a method for constructing the perpendicular bisector of a line segment using the fact that the diagonals of a rhombus bisect each other at right angles. I hope you found this video useful. Thanks for watching.